Yo, what's up, y'all? This is St. Joe, SoundsAndGear.com. We're here with the very first episode of Learn Your Gear. I got my compadres with me. Today's episode, we're going to be talking about a question that we all get a lot, which is, what do I start with? But before we jump into it, we're just going to do some quick introductions. And of course, we're going to start with Stoney first. Those of you who don't know Stoney, just a quick introduction, Stoney, for those that may not know who you are and what you do.
Okay, my name is Stoney. I'm a music producer. I also worked as a recording engineer in New York for a couple of years. Product specialist, you know, for Pro Tools, Native Instruments. Currently, I'm a mentor at the Pure Mind website, where you could come and like get mentorship from me and learn about mastering anything from Ableton to MPC to machine, everything, Reason. But currently I'm, you know, DJing and producing, and it's a pleasure being here with you guys.
Definitely.
I look forward to just sharing and having some fun.
Awesome. Next, we'll move over to my main man, Dilly. Man, please introduce yourself for those who may not know who you are.
What's up? My name is Dilly. I represent DillyOTK.com, bringing you music production, sound design, native, massive sound design, pop boxing, the FL Studio production, Studio 1-3 production, Pro Tools, Moog, analog sound design on there, going from the sub Fatty to the sub 37, Model D, and back again. All kinds of variety stuff, and just ready to have some fun.
Yeah, and you're an artist. Let's not forget that. You are an artist. You are working on an album. Make sure we always plug album. That, bro. You know.
Yes, sir.
Excited. Yeah. So we go over to my man, Sean. What's up, Sean?
What's up, y'all? Sean Devine, pleasure to be here. I'm a producer, mix engineer, sound designer. Got started making beats, but all that just kind of, you know, parlayed into these other things. So looking forward to hearing everybody's perspectives.
Definitely. Then we'll move it over to my man TDS up in Canada. What's up, bro?
Not bad. How's everyone doing? I'm the Daydream Sound. I'm just a guy that uses old samplers to make new music.
That's what's up. And my bro, Elib, down in Texas. What's up, man? Let the people know.
It's an honor to be here right now. I pretty much got my start playing drums. That's how I started. And I'm a music composer. I have several placements on major TV networks, and my main thing is in Studio One. I'm also an expert in machine and trying to get up there with Stoney, you know. But that's pretty much what I do.
That's what's up, man. And for those of you who don't know me, man, St. Joe, just an audio geek, you know, mentor, educator, producer. I'm not gonna say all that, but yo, I just love music and love helping people find the tools that they need to create. So like I said, today's topic is all of us, you know, have our own channels, and you can find the links below, and we all share and educate people. And I know we all get this question all the time is, you know, what do I get starting out, or what do I get first, or, you know, how do I get started? And so we're just going to have everybody kind of give their own perspective on what they would tell somebody, like, say, hey, you know, if you're in a school or you're in a class or you're in a conference or something, and somebody stops you and you got like 5 to 7 minutes to kind of talk with them about what they should get, what you would tell them. And once again, we'll just start ladies first. We'll go with Stoney, and I know she gets this question often.
Starting out, are we talking about producers? Are we talking about
it can be whatever you want.
I mean, for me, the first thing before you decide, you know, what you like, as far as producers are concerned, I don't know. I always feel like from a technical perspective, you know, find a DAW that you can, that speaks to you, right? Find one DAW, just one thing, and master that one thing.
Right.
You know, the trend I notice is, you know, everybody, anything that's new that comes out, they want to grab something new. Everybody wants to have 2 or 3 different platforms at the same time that they want to learn. And I just think, you know, getting the fundamentals and your foundation in order by using one tool. And that one tool, I think, you know, picking a DAW, kind of a DAW, D-A-W, you know, gives you everything in one package. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? And then when you're picking your DAW, kind of like pick something that when you see it, when you use it, it speaks to you, right? I mean, we have so many choices now. And if you're not having fun using it and it doesn't speak to the way that you process,
right?
You know what I mean? You process audio, you process technology. So that's one thing I would recommend is pick one thing to master. Gotcha. And when I say master, I mean like you should be on this one thing for about a year.
Gotcha.
Give it a year. Mm-hmm. You know, I have people come to me and they're like, I want to master Ableton in 2 months.
Yeah.
That's not going to happen. And then learn music, like not music theory per se, but like learn the business that you're trying to get into. Mm. So you want to make beats, you know, invest in yourself, take some classes, speak to somebody who knows way more than you and sit with them and watch them work and, you know, try to become a mentee, you know, and offer something to your mentor so that you can be of value and you could share information. But I think when you're first starting out, just keep it super duper simple and don't spend all this money on all this expensive stuff while you're learning. You know, you should take that money and put it more into, you know, the classes or the, you know, the information as opposed to buying a lot of gear.
Yeah,
you know, that's what I've noticed that people do.
Yeah.
That's, I mean, there's so much more that I could go into, you know, but just starting out as a producer, pick a DAW, pick one and just stick to that. And don't waste your time. You know, like honestly put hours into it.
Yeah.
You know, every day you should be opening up that DAW and learning something new every day. And then repetition is
definitely
everything.
Definitely. Dope. One of the dope things you said that I wasn't expecting, but it's really, really, really dope is learning what it is that you're trying to do and investing in yourself there. Like, you know, most people, when they say, what should I get first? They start naming all this gear. And I like the fact that you were like, you need to get some get some knowledge about what it is that you're trying to do. Like at least some type of understanding in the background of what it is that you're trying to do. So that kind of leads you along the path of knowing what you should get, you know? So,
I mean, I had a guy come to me and he had Ableton, he had Machine Studio, he had everything and he didn't understand what quantize meant.
Right.
And I was just like, wow, you know, and then he kept saying, well, my friend said I need battery. My friend said I need this. And he went and bought all this stuff and spent all this money when all he needed was just one of those tools and just investing in getting the information and how to use it and why he's using it.
Nice.
You know, that's what dope. Kind of music do you want to do? What genre are you talking about? What type of sound you should be using? It's so many different layers. But if you just one thing at a time and then like, try not to be so fashionable, right? Like, okay, and the new machine is out or the new MPC is out and you want to get the new thing, you have the old piece. You still don't know your old piece. Master what you have. Mm. Like, make sense of what you have already instead of, like, just trying to get what everybody else has.
Dope.
Can I come in on that one?
Absolutely.
Go ahead, brother.
Yeah, I agree with what she said, like, 100%. And that's the reason why I center myself. I mean, if you guys can see, it's getting dark here, but I have simple things going on.
Yeah.
And when I go and teach courses and tutorials online, I have all of this stuff. I have drums. Like I said, I started out playing drums. I have organ and all that stuff is in the storage, but that doesn't mean nothing to the producers today because I tell people it's all about you. It's not the stuff that you have that will make you hits. It's going to be you, your laptop, and that's what's making the hits. These young kids out here, they don't need all that stuff. They making beats, making hits right there in their bedroom.
Yeah.
But we have other people who's trying to get all these things, thinking that they're going to be anything greater, have all the latest and greatest. I mean, just like she said, just pick one thing, master that, and make that your own, and that's it. Yeah. If you're trying to get all the, you know, master too many, I think it was a saying, a master I can't remember how it goes, but you guys know what I'm trying to say. Yeah. You can't master everything because it'll just be mumble jumble that comes out. You know what I mean? You never get nothing wrong, nothing done.
As a perfect example, I don't know, you guys know Henny from the business.
Mm-hmm.
got a YouTube channel,
Adventures in Beatmaking,
doing some amazing stuff with his iPad Pro, and he's killing it. Like he's killing it. He's got his sound. He's got his devices. You know, all his little gadgets to make his iPad Pro work. That's
dope too.
And he is killing them. The tracks are insane, and the videos are entertaining. He's not using anything that is like super unattainable. You know what I mean? Like anybody can get an iPad, or, you know, and you don't have to use a Pro. You could use whatever you have, you know, but he's showing you like you can actually do this stuff with an iPad. Mm-hmm. And it's dope.
Yeah. Yeah, definitely. You know? Yeah. That's what's up. That's what's up. Dilly, man. So I know you get this question a lot. what is your typical response to people? Because usually the people that are asking this question are people who really are just getting started. They really don't know which way they want to go yet. Right. Most of the time.
What I like to do is come up with a package of a simple answer for them to go to. Because like I said, you got a whole world of options. So typically when someone comes to me and asks me, hey, man, why do I need to get started? Give me your top five tips on how to get started. You know what I'm saying? What software I get? I tell them to go grab FL Studio. This is the reason why I tell them to go get FL Studio. Step one, it's free. Two, you got all the things in there you need to learn how to use everything. You got EQs. You have compression. Inside the mixing architecture, you have signal and sidechain routing that you can do. It comes with a set of VST plugins. All this stuff is for free, right? So I think that a lot of times people are worried about financial decisions and stuff like that. Or if someone's coming out, 9 times out of 10, if they're just getting started in music, they're not even used to the idea of spending money on Ableton Push or Eagle Machine, because they're dropping at least $500 or $600 there. That's why I say, hey, go get this free program right here. All the stuff is in there. There's tons of tutorials of it online that they can go to. So in a nutshell, in a very condensed nutshell, when someone says, hey, where do I get to start? Just go grab FL Studio for free. Start there.
I'm using a Mac.
As far as you just going to the Mac, that's a great question.
Logic Pro.
Well, I tell them go get on Pro. If they got a Mac, if they got a Mac, let's talk about that. If they got a Mac, I tell them go ahead and get on GarageBand. GarageBand has EQs. GarageBand has instruments.
Yeah.
You understand what I'm saying? And so basically, to me, GarageBand is pretty much an abbreviated version of Logic, right? Yeah. Mm-hmm. So I think that it's very important to feel free to try either one. That one for Mac. And like I said, if you're on PC, go ahead and use FL Studio. And I believe ImageLine is working on, and I've actually worked with the alpha or the beta, whatever it is, that's not finished. And I actually enjoyed it. It actually reminded me of a lot of things I missed, because I don't have a lot of things that I have now, vice versa. So with that being said, if you're on a PC, go ahead and get your FL Studio for free. You got all the stuff in there. You want to learn about how to mix stuff like that? You got to reverb, delays, all that. It's all there. It's a lot of stuff, but you want to learn with the minimum amount of investment. Start. Okay, Mac side. Let's go to GarageBand. That a lot of great sounding. Also a great DAW as well. FL Studio is also a DAW as well. So,
you
know, I think I always like to come from the option of, okay, let's get the money out of the picture and get to creating. Grab this or that.
Definitely.
Dope. So, Sean, what about you, man? Like, I know you probably get this question, but I wonder who asks you this question the most. Like, do you get it more from guys trying to become mixing engineers, or do you get it more from producers, or is it about equal for you?
It's about equal, but more these days is kind of in the mixing realm. Mm-hmm. And I just want to go back and say all three of the responses before me, like everybody out there, rewind it and listen to that back. I know that, you know, there were some simpler concepts there that maybe you're thinking that, you know, you need to hear this complex answer of like, oh, get this piece of equipment and this piece of gear. And, you know, once you have this, you're going to be ready to do it. It's not that complicated. Like, you really just need to learn what you have, start simply, you know, just kind of go through the motions of really getting familiar with the tools that you start with. And it's all about the user. Mm-hmm. You know, I think it was Elob that was talking about, just, you know, it's not the gear. It's, we all love the gear. They're great tools. And it's like paintbrushes for our craft, right? But at the end of the day, it's about the user. And it's about the time that you invest in the craft. And that's going to get you to where you need to be. So with that said, going back to the mixing stuff, you know, my recommendation these days would be to get a laptop. And like Stoney was saying, find a DAW that inspires you just off the jump. Like when you're looking at it, it's like, okay, you know, I feel most comfortable in this environment. And once you find that one, like try out, you know, a couple of different ones, go to your buddy's house, try something, get in a studio, mess with Pro Tools and figure out which one speaks to you. And then once you do, settle on that and stick with it for a while and produce, mix, do sound design, all that stuff, master, do everything in that DAW and get really comfortable with it. Use stock plugins. It's okay to use stock plugins. Like there's so many great stock plugins in DAWs these days. Like most people are asking me, do I need to go buy Waves, Diamond, and you know, all this stuff? Like, do not do that starting out because it's just going to confuse you. You're going to be sitting there with 300 plugins and you're not going to know how to use any of them. You're not going to know what they do essentially at the core level. So with the stock plugins, you're just going to have a compressor that you can get comfortable with compression. You got an EQ that you can learn basic EQ with. Then you can move on and say, all right, you know, let me get some of these more advanced tools. So that's really what I've got for mix engineers is just start simply, get a DAW you're comfortable with, get some good speakers, get something that you understand how they translate. So that's really helpful, and get a good audio interface. That's also really helpful.
Now, as an engineer, what are some things you kind of advise people to look for in a monitor? Speakers.
Starting out, it's tough because you're not necessarily going to be familiar with a certain monitor. So my advice is always to, you know, go to the store if you can, get in a studio and listen to some speakers. And in the same kind of sense that you're getting used to a DAW, figure out which monitor kind of sounds the most, not exciting, but something that just inspires you. Like you hear it and you're like, oh, that's pleasing to my ears, but it still sounds accurate. You know, it's not like, you know, making the bass so loud that it's going to not translate, you know what I mean? But still something that's your preference. And once you've got that narrowed down, you really just need to learn the speaker. So that's listening to a ton of music, studying music, listening to different types of music on that speaker. Like don't just listen to hip hop. If you're a hip hop mixer, producer, listen to all types of music on that speaker and learn how it reacts to a lot of your favorite mixes, you know, favorite masters, stuff from your favorite albums, hear how it sounds on that speaker and just stick with that speaker for as long as possible. You know, you can mix on $200 speakers. You can mix on $100 headphones. As long as you know it and you know how to compensate for it when you take it to a different environment. It's cool. You know, you don't have to have crazy speakers. That said, you may want to think about some treatment and you don't have to go like tearing down walls or anything like that, but you want to eliminate as much, you know, echo and reverberation as possible just to get the most out of the speakers. That definitely helps as well.
Can I piggyback off of what Sean is saying?
Yeah, definitely.
You know, a lot of times, you know, and I agree with everything you're saying, Sean, like you're hitting it spot on, you know, but before you can even get there, you have to be about this life.
Absolutely.
And when I say about this life, everybody in the room automatically goes, and then you guys totally understand what that means. You know, I get asked tons of questions all the time, Joe. And, you know, the first thing everybody's like, you know, I'm a mom, you know what I mean? I have a family and you have to be able to balance this thing out. You know what I mean? And then you have to be willing to make the sacrifice for the art and for you to learn the stuff. You know, I could tell you, go get a dog. We could sit here and say, get treatment, get mics, get this, get that. And you could have all the gear and it could sit there and collect dust.
Got to put in the work.
You know? But if you don't maintain your life, the way that you live, the things that you do day to day, what you do when you wake up in the morning, what you're eating, how you feel, you know, and there's this trend with producers where it's like, yo, I did 20 beats today. Yo, I ain't sleep in 2 days. Well, if you don't sleep, you are not going to hear properly. You know what I'm saying? You don't eat properly and you don't work out and you don't take care of yourself. All these things that you're doing, you're investing, and even in the way that you communicate to people, the way that you're communicating with yourself, pause. You know, you have to be able to maintain your life. Yeah. You understand what I'm saying?
Definitely. Yeah.
You know, I bump into producers and they was like, yo, you know, I've been on machine and I've been doing this, and I'm just like, what did you do this week? How many times did you turn it on?
Yeah.
Oh, now I was with my mans and them. I had to go into this party, or yeah, I was watching this TV show, and yo, I was watching this, and I'm just like, okay, yeah. There's a time to have a good time. But when you're first starting out, you gotta like go in. Right. Like you have to literally put your head down and stay in your DAW,
yeah,
day and night, and like balance it.
Yeah.
You gotta put tons of time into it.
Definitely.
But yeah. Nothing's gonna happen if you're not really about that life, like dedicating, like really taking care of yourself and maintaining yourself so that you can actually process the information. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Like
yeah.
I have people that book sessions with me and they want to book 2-3 hours. I'm like, after 2 hours, you're not going to retain anything that I'm saying.
Right.
There's no way that you're going to keep it from that.
Yeah.
So, you know, an hour of a little bit of this, an hour of content, and then an hour of actually application.
Yeah.
Like you take an hour of learning something and then you spend 2, 3, 4. I might do a session with somebody for 1 hour in a week. That entire week, I want them to practice whatever I showed them for 7 days straight.
Yeah.
I won't even do more than one session with somebody.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Because they're just starting out. They have to retain it, and it's repetition. And,
you're right.
You know, but you have to really be about this life and be serious.
Definitely, definitely.
No question. Yeah. No question. I agree 150%. And just, you know, summing up what Stoney said, which, I mean, nailed it.
Yeah.
It's like, before you even start thinking about the tools and all that, like if you really feel like you're passionate about this, get your mind right and your heart right, because this is not for everybody. And I don't say that like in an egotistical way. I'm just saying that in terms of the dedication, you got to put the hours in. That's it. You know, it's like, you just got to be really, really true to it about that life, like Stoney was saying.
Definitely.
And it's the commitment.
Definitely. Yo.
Yeah, a lot of people looking at this thing as a trend, man.
Right.
Right.
Right. Definitely. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
That's real life.
That's definitely true.
And they think it's fancy, too. They think it's fancy. And they think, like, and it's funny because, like, there's this, like producers who get like all this shine and notoriety, a lot of them were like artists or DJs, you know, like Pharrell was an artist, Tim was a DJ and an artist. Like these guys were artists, and like producers want to be seen now. And it's just like, dude, like you want to be seen, but you don't even know how to mix your records. Come on, boy. Like,
Yeah, that's real. I mean, you definitely.
And there's that trend too. Yeah, I'm a producer. I don't need to know how to do this or that. You do need to know something, my dude. Like something.
Mm-hmm.
I can't walk in there and do like everything, and you don't know what a record button is. That's a problem.
Right. And I know that you got some stories. That. I know the stories. We might have to touch on that on another episode.
You know, just because like, okay, you're starting out. The one thing you always want to do too is be as self-contained as possible.
Mm-hmm.
You know, make it where at least you know how to use whatever tool you have to the fullest, where you don't have to have, like, you ain't got to call Sean like, hey man, I know I made the beat, but how do I track this out?
Yeah.
Like at least by the time it gets to him, to the engineer, you know what your song is doing. You understand your you know, because he might not know FL.
Mm-hmm.
And you walk to a studio and assume the engineer is going to know your software.
Mm.
You know what I mean? Like you're responsible as a producer, you're responsible for, you know, what you're producing.
Definitely.
You know your tools. And again, there's different types of producers.
Right.
I know a bunch of guys that don't know this stuff. They get in the studio and they produce amazing records.
Yeah.
I know, I get that.
But
for the cats that want to be hands-on,
yeah.
Man, master your shit, B.
Yeah, no doubt. So Daydream, man. I'm interested in your what you say to people when they ask you this question, because I know you get the question as well. And the reason I'm interested is because I know when people see you, they see you using hardware, and specifically a lot of classic hardware. When they ask you, what should I get? Are they asking you, which old sampler should I get? or are they asking, like, in kind of how do you approach it?
I get two pointed questions. One is definitely the hardware thing, like what sampler do I get? And mostly like, how do they deal with the software? How do I expand it? How do I plug a USB cable? They're just stuff because of the generation gap. It's just hard for them to think of something that
doesn't,
you can only access via a floppy disk. And I get that.
Right.
So most of the time when I get that type of question, I try my best to steer them away from it.
Mm-hmm.
Because there's always a form of disappointment. There's so many times where I've spoken to people, I'm like, you may want to get something more modern. They're like, no, I want to get this sampler. And then they get it and they get disappointed because of, they don't know how to deal with it.
Right.
Which is cool. And there's very few people that I run into that just get it right off the bat. I could only think of one that comes to mind that bought an old sampler and he just took to it, you know, kid born in the 90s.
Yeah.
It comes from him just doing that much research, an astounding amount of research, where he just took to it. I've never seen anything like that, to be honest.
Yeah.
What piece was it?
EPS 16 Plus.
Oh, that was my first keyboard.
The joint, right? That's my favorite, right?
So, my first keyboard, I swear to God. No
Yeah. So, you know, that's the biggest thing that I see. So I educate them at first and I'm like, if you really want to do this, you have to slow down your expectations.
Gotcha.
You know, you have to, you know, understand the limitations and all of that, which it never really works out that way.
Yeah.
I think that this, at this point, the nostalgia about older gear is so large. Yeah. It's larger than it was before. I don't know why, but I guess there's a resurgence of boom bap and there's only a certain amount of equipment that produce that sort of gear, that sort of sound. So the second question I get is how to get the sound out of it. Because once you get the gear, you realize it's not the gear at all.
Yeah.
Like this gear doesn't sound that fantastic.
Right.
You know, the grit is there, everything's there, but that sound that you're looking for comes from your ability to translate. So this is, I find it's the easier thing to explain to people when they ask that sort of question. And I find that I encourage people to just listen.
Mm-hmm.
You know, before I ever made any type of beat, I used to listen to everything, and I still do. You know, listen to not only music, but listen to your girlfriend snoring beside you when you wake up in the morning. Just understand what sound is, what it can do for you, and how you can get what's in your head out of your head.
Mm.
And that's the biggest thing. People, we all have, how do I say this? We all have an intention in our mind of what something is supposed to sound like. The biggest problem is, how do you get it out?
Definitely.
And the only way you're going to do that is to become very familiar with yourself and sound.
Mm-hmm.
And when you get to that point, it doesn't matter what gear you're using. It doesn't matter anything. You could just get it out because you're very familiar how to get the sound out of you.
Yeah.
And that's the biggest thing I tell people, because once you get into this music thing, you're forever changed. You're never going to be a fan like you used to be.
Definitely.
Because you know what it takes to make it. So there's no going back once you go into that, you know, once you decide to go that realm, it's the end of the road.
It is. And like you said, it's never going to be the same, because my wife always, she laughs at me, man, and they get a kick out of it. Now it's like, anytime I see a performance and I see stuff on stage, I'm like, yo, that's a Phantom. That's a Motif. Yo, he got a Nord. Dog, he got a Kronos. He got this. And then to the point now where, like, anytime she sees a picture or, you know, a performance, she's like, what's that? And I'm like, that's this, and this. And it's like, it's so natural because that's what you're about. But, I mean, even everything that everybody has said, it still goes back to a lot of what Stoney said in the beginning as well, man, which is really dope. It's just that understanding of what it is you want to do. Like, everybody's saying it in different ways, but it comes down to knowing, like you said, knowing yourself, knowing what it is that you want to do, and being able to translate that to whatever it is you have.
But you know what, though, JK, that also speaks to just the way that the world works right now.
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
It speaks to culture.
Mm-hmm.
Like, it speaks to culture because in different cultures, it's translated different, you know, and when I'm not in the States.
Yeah.
Are different, you know, when I'm in New York, the questions are different.
Gotcha.
Than when I'm in Canada or, you know, other places, you know, and when I say like it's culturally, what I mean is like, you know, we're in a culture in New York, you know, producers are following each other.
Gotcha.
Uh-huh. Yo, Machine is what's hopper. Yeah. I want that right now too.
Yeah.
You know, NPC X coming out. Yo, I'm getting me one. You got one? Yo, I got the Jordans. You got some Jordans? You know what I mean? Like, it's trendy, gotcha. You know, and, yeah. You know, culturally, like, you know, and to piggyback off of what he was saying about, you know, the resurgence of hardware and everything, you know, because of live performance now, definitely. You know, it's super cool to have gadgets.
Yeah,
yeah.
Gadgets on stage. I love it, but a lot of the times it's only because their favorite producer had it. So now they have to have it.
Well, yeah, you know, I mean, when I go on Instagram and I see Stoney doing something like this and it's making her beat stutter and loop and everything, I'm trying to figure out what this box is she got. You know what I'm saying? So yeah, I mean, it's true. It's like, but that's the thing. It's like, you know your gear. And so, and like,
but
it goes back.
Here's the crazy part about that is somebody will actually go buy the box, right? And they get it and they do this and then they'll email me and go,
it don't work. but it's the same as with
you
TDS.
You didn't ask me before you bought it. You just went and bought it. You didn't even know what it was.
But it's the same as what TDS was saying. It's like they expect it to just automatically produce what they're looking for, and it's like you got to understand it, you got to know it, be able to translate. Elib, I know you touched on it earlier, man, but you know, I want to come back to you again and just give you a little bit more time if you got anything else to say in terms of the types of questions you may get along these lines, because I know you do a lot of educating as well, like everybody else here. So I'm wondering, what types of questions do you get along the lines of people trying to get started?
It's pretty much on the same borderline as what we discussed. And now, you know, I do a lot of the YouTube tutorials, and I started out in Logic, and well, actually, I started out before then, but as far as computer,
right?
I started out in Pro Tools, but Logic was my thing. Is, you know, when I went live on YouTube or whatever, and a lot of my followers seen the switch when I made the switch from Logic to Studio One.
Yep.
And so I get questions about, you know, what DAW is best, and then I have people saying, my dog's better than yours. I get a lot of those too. But I mean, it just comes back to what I said earlier. I mean, like, it doesn't. And when I produce my content, it's not only geared towards Studio One users. I try to say, well, this is geared towards music production in general.
Yeah.
So if you can like achieve the stutter effect or reverb or compression, all DAW has this in there. You know, and you know, you have all these things you can do. You can pretty much the same thing in every DAW. So I try to keep it on that line, and it's just really more so like, you know, like we've been saying, just learn your DAW, learn who you are, learn your gear.
Yeah. No, that's dope.
Simple,
man.
Simple.
But yeah, that's what it is, man. Which is dope, man. And for me. I'm like everybody else. You guys know me. I use whatever speaks to you. But I think if I'm gonna narrow it down to the types of questions I get, a lot of times the people that ask me those questions are cats that came up the same way a lot of us came up. They come up on that hardware, so they're really looking to translate their hardware workflow to software. And there, a lot of times people come to me and they're like, man, I don't really want a DAW. I don't really want to, like me, I don't really want to map stuff. I don't really want to do all this. And so the questions I get the most are, obviously, do I get Machine? Do I get an MPC? Or do I get Ableton Push? For me, those are the questions I get more than anything. And obviously, I'm like, they all can do similar things. Like, you can pretty much get the same thing done in each one. It's all about understanding your workflow and what you're trying to do. But for me, at the end of the day, it's like, if it comes down to workflow and you want something that's really kind of easy to get your ideas down, then I kind of suggest, okay, Machine. And I wouldn't even say Studio. If somebody was just starting out, I would say get an MK2. You know what I'm saying? But if you're somebody that is maybe like Sean that has guitars and you have these other things in the background and you want to record audio and things like this, then I'm like, I wouldn't lean them towards machine. I would say you probably want to lean more towards Ableton Live and maybe try to pick up a push or even a used push, just because of the way it handles audio. And speaking of Ableton Live, shout out to Stoney. She was on the one thing with Ableton, the new series. That was dope. She was talking about the beat warping and turning loops into percussive stuff. So if you're really, really into audio, then I kind of suggest going that way. But then, you know, if you're somebody that's linear, I would probably say, you know, check out Studio One. But I've even suggested things like, even though I'm not an FL Studio user, I'm like, if you're really into step sequencing and things like that, then so for me, it's not a one size fits all. It's a, I always ask them, when people ask me, what do I get? I say, well, what are you trying to do? What do you want? What is your workflow? Like, are you trying to DJ? Are you trying to make beats? Are you trying to chop samples? Are you trying to record, you know, instruments? Like, what are you trying to do? And then I can better give you, you know, an idea. And then obviously, if they're on a PC, I have to suggest some type of audio interface, like something basic, at least with, you know, two inputs that you can get some good latency. But, you know, if they're on a MacBook or something like that, like a lot of times you can get away with not having an interface on a Mac, you know, because of the way that the Core Audio works. You can sometimes get away with production just getting started straight with your MacBook. You know, on a PC, it's not as good on that way, unless you're using something like ASIO for All or something. But I think it goes back to what you want to do, and then I can give you an idea. You know what I'm saying? And I think the overall theme is there is no magic tool. Like, you can't just say, somebody's not just going to be able to give you a list and then you go get this list and now you're just making beats exactly how you hear them in your head. Like, no matter what you get, you're going to have to learn it, right? And I think that's pretty much what everybody's saying in their own way, which is dope. But I know we all get that and we all answer that multiple times a week. And it's like, well, what do you want to do? Like, before I can tell you what to get, you know, I need to know what you want. I mean, and that's a huge responsibility, because I know a lot of people come to us and they're like, yo, man, I got this much money. I need to know what to get. Yo, so you make it like, so now I'm spending your money for you. So I really need to know exactly, you know what I'm saying? I can't just tell you to go get this because it may be something I like. Like, there's a lot of times I'll suggest something to somebody that I personally it may not be my favorite thing, but I'm like, you probably want to get this because that sounds more like, you know, what is going to fit for you, even though that's not really my thing. Like, you may want to go get FL Studio because of this, 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 and this. I don't use it, but I know a lot of people that do, and this is why they use it. So you might want to go get that type of thing.
It's something else I say, like, when people ask me that, I also ask them why.
Yeah.
I like to know, what is your reason behind wanting to, because if you never had experience before, you know, that kind of help leads my answer and what I may say next.
Yeah. I mean, a lot of times I tell people to get an app on their iPad or their phone. Like, you know, try iMachine, try BeatMaker, try BeatHawk, try Core Gadget. See if you even into this, really.
Yeah,
you know what I'm saying? Like, that's 10-20 bucks. Yeah, you know what I'm saying? Like,
well, usually, see, that would work if that person, you know, was self-driven. You know, usually a lot of guys want to mimic something that they've heard already.
That's true.
A lot of times people are like, well, I want the MPC because I heard so-and-so do a beat and he made this sound like this.
Yeah.
I want to achieve what he's doing.
True.
You know what I'm saying? But
definitely,
you don't have his drums.
Right.
You don't have his ears.
Yeah.
Like, I can give you the exact same sounds I'm using. You are never going to sound like me, ever.
Yeah, it's the truth.
Right.
You don't have, like, I hear my room is different than your room.
Yeah.
My mold in that day felt different than when you felt, you know, and then, yeah. So a lot of times cats can't tell you what they want because they don't know what they want. They just want what they see somebody else has.
That's true.
And then at some point while they're searching, they find their own voice.
Yeah.
It's okay. It's okay to say, okay, I'm inspired by so-and-so and I saw so-and-so with the machine and I like what she's doing and I want to, you know, emulate it. Cool. Yeah. But after a while, you're emulating it.
Right.
You know, it's not your voice. And then once you learn the technique, you kind of find your own voice within, you know, find your direction. But most people most people are inspired by someone else first.
Yeah, you know? definitely. Yeah.
Oh. That goes back to what Daydream was saying.
Yeah.
You buy the equipment and you shocked because it don't sound the way you thought it sound.
Yeah.
I got one better for you. I had a dude come up to me. He was like, "Yo, Stoney, man, I went and bought this complete control keyboard. That's when I was touring."
Yeah.
And bought the keyboard.
Yeah.
So I got home, I plugged it in, and I can't hear shit.
Yeah.
I was like, you need to buy the software.
Yeah.
But that's how deep it is. You know, clearly saw somebody with the keyboard or saw the keyboard and was like, yo, this person is slaying this keyboard.
Yeah.
But didn't understand what was happening.
Didn't do that research. It goes back to that research.
That stack.
Yeah.
Went the stack and then got home and plugged in and it's like, you know, and then people overestimate also.
Yeah.
They see you do it, they see you plug it in and you killing it, and they feel like, oh, I could do it.
Yeah.
No, you're not, there are levels to this shit.
Yeah, you gotta put in that time.
No disrespect, and this is not ego, but there are levels. Yeah. Like, we put years into this, so you think you're gonna just turn your shit on and do what I'm doing?
Yeah.
Really?
Right.
It's just not that easy.
Right. We're not in the Casio industry.
Definitely.
No, what I'm saying, a lot of people, they see it and look, we make it look really easy.
Yeah, yeah.
Like pressing the buttons, if it, wow, that looks like I could just flow.
Yeah.
But there's so many layers behind that. You know what I'm saying? Like,
definitely.
Absolutely.
Machine, and I'm just like, well, you don't know my resume.
Yeah.
I've worked at Hit Factory. I've mixed records. I've done all the different things that brought me to, by the time I got on a machine, I'm going to fly in it because I've done all this other stuff that I can apply the same information.
Most definitely.
To this. I can take this concept and just apply it to new technology.
Yeah, and that, it goes back to what Daydream was saying, man. Like, once you know, you can translate it. Definitely, man. So I mean, I think that's a good way to kind of end it, man. I think it was really dope. Definitely love hearing everybody's perspective, and I think it goes back to just knowing what it is you want to do. And doing the research and putting in the time, man.
Can I ask one question before we leave?
Yeah.
What's everybody's favorite piece right now?
Oh gosh.
Favorite what?
Everybody's favorite piece. What is your go-to thing right now that you love?
Mine's is the Rhodes. It's always gonna be the Rhodes.
The Rhodes. It's the machine for me.
The Rhodes.
Right now.
I start everything with the Rhodes.
I'm gonna have to go with SSL plugins.
Ooh.
For me, for today, it's the Octatrack. Tomorrow, it's gonna be something.
Yeah, I guess for me right now, it's LA.
What'd you say?
LA 610.
Nice.
Dope. So that's what it is, man. Make sure y'all come over to the Facebook group, facebook.com/group/learnyourgear, where you can interact with us, ask questions, suggest topics. We're just trying to build a community, see what you guys want to know about, and just share our perspective. Before we go, does anybody got anything that they want to share that they got going on coming up? I know, Stoney, you got the Paramind mentoring and everything. Anything else?
Mentoring, and my website, please go to it. It's a Stoney's World, STONIS world.com. Please come to my YouTube page, follow me on, you know, subscribe to my YouTube page. I have a bunch of content that I'm going to be posting up. And that's Stoney's Music, STONIS Music. Ask me questions here and, you know, book sessions with me on the Paramind platform as well. And, you know, come and master your craft.
Dope. Dilly, you got anything that's going on you want the people to know about, or?
Absolutely. I guess the first thing I just want to go ahead and just say is that Magic Box album is the album. And also, make sure to check my YouTube channel, LTK. Check out LTK.com.
Dope. What about you, Sean? What you got going on, man?
You can find me on SeanDevine.com if you're looking for mixing and mastering. If you want to learn mixing and mastering, I go to my YouTube page, youtube.com/SeanDevine. I also just put out a course with Linda, LinkedIn Learning, called Hip Hop Vocal Production.
Yep.
You want to check that out. And yeah, man.
Dope, dope.
Honor to be with y'all, by the way. This is really fun.
I'm glad you guys were able to make it. What about TDS, Daydream, what you got going on? Any?
The same business as usual. Yeah. YouTube, find me there, thedaydreamsound.com. Facebook, regular label life.
Yeah.
Just find me online.
Dope, dope, dope. And Ella, what you got? I know you got all types of stuff going on. What's the latest for you this week? For this month, well, or this, right now.
Everyone can find me on ksound.com, mm-hmm. in case you guys didn't know. That's how you find my all of my social links and stuff that I'm currently doing.
Yeah.
That also leads into my the school I have, the artistsound.university, where I am currently working on how to mix vocals inside of Studio One. So something to look forward to pretty soon.
Dope, dope, dope. And y'all know where to find me, man. Sounds and Gear everywhere. You know what it is. Always got something going on. Make sure you subscribe to the channel. Make sure you subscribe to everybody else's channel. You can see the links below. I'll put them in the description. Make sure you come up to the Facebook group. And yeah, we'll see y'all again. We're going to do this once a month. So the next one is going to be coming up next month after you see this one. And yeah, make sure you come in and just interact with us and let us know the type of stuff that you want to see covered. Again, thanks to everybody for taking time out. I know everybody got stuff going on. I just appreciate y'all. And that's what it is, man. We'll see y'all later.
Peace.
Peace.